Let me identify what animation should be. That was decided not by me and not by animators. It was decided by a man named Noah Webster. And Noah, around 1848 or something along in there, he wrote a dictionary. And he put down the word animation. And the explanation was to invoke life.
Here in the United States, animation is perceived as something just for kids, but that attitude is changing. A new direction in animation is presenting us with humor that is more sophisticated and themes that are more mature.
Welcome back.
In Japan, animation has never been just for kids. Its themes and content have targeted adult audiences for decades, and its style, known as anime, is creating a buzz here in the United States.
I don't think animation is just for kids. I never will believe that.
When I say adult-oriented, everyone in America automatically thinks I'm talking about adult movies or X movies.
There's a sort of age hierarchy that most Americans abide by, and they categorize anything in that area, comics or animation, as being less than serious.
I think we all grew up with cartoons and animation, and as young adults and adults, we feel that it's a meaningful medium for us.
It's an opportunity to use the medium and just get out there and say, we can make you laugh as adults, and we can take advantage of your entertainment time by giving you something that's not going to insult you, but you're going to laugh at.
Look at your after-school product, and look at your Saturday morning product, and look at the cartoon channels that are out there. And there's very few products that are offered to an adult environment.
He's not meaner than Sparky.
Oh yeah? Let's see. Hey, Sylvester!
Sparky will kick his ass.
I'll put a dollar on Sylvester.
You're on, dude. That's it, Sparky.
He's doing something to his ass. He's not kicking his ass, but he's definitely doing something to his ass.
Sparky! Bad dog!
What? Yeah, dude, I think your dog is gay.
What do you mean?
That dog is a gay homosexual.
The Simpsons changed everything.
I think you say adult animation, that's the wrong... That is a term for, like, X-rated, you know,
that's like
cartoon.
Adult movie, adult video,
right,
you know?
It's family animation or whatever you want to call it. Most people don't even think about The Simpsons as animated.
People, that was all wrong. Homer Simpson doesn't say bow, he says... Doe!
It is a common practice for many U.S. shows to be animated in Asia. Fully 90% of U.S. animation is shipped overseas because of costs and the volume of material. But some shows are looking for a specific quality associated with Japan's own animation, an animation style called Japanimation, also known as anime.
The Japanese have literally for decades been doing the animation that I'm surprised has never come to this country. And I wanted to see if I couldn't bring a little bit of that flavor in.
We went through the steps of hiring a Japanese studio to bring an influence of an anime style to Spawn. So we pushed the amount of detail and atmosphere that we're trying to get, again, taking a bit of a lead from anime sensibility.
Japanese animation, while it is still animation, it has a very different look. It has a harder edge, very kinetic style, very action, also very violent. American cartoons haven't been action-oriented for a very long time, since we were kids.
In Japan, they found a niche that works. But I believe that it adds a lot of action and it adds a lot of energy. They're very skilled at giving you the illusion that you are seeing far more than you're actually looking at, and that there's actually less being animated than what you thought with your eye. And that, to me, is called style.
Japanese animation, even the most mediocre title, has an amazingly deep story. There's always emotional content. If you watch them, it's not stuff that a kid can watch and just like, you know, eat popcorn. You have to think. It forces you to think.
The creator of Princess Mononoke is Mr. Hayao Miyazaki, often referred to in the media as the Walt Disney of Japan.
Disney's story structure is often very simple, which either disappoints me or makes me envious. I don't know which. I don't create stories that are just for children, or stories that have to be entertaining, as so often happens in American animation. In my work, I try to address some of the problems of the moment in a creative way.
Anime has been an underground phenomenon in the US for a number of years, but the first anime titles to significantly break into the American market were Akira and Ghost in the Shell.
Ghost in the Shell was a first in animation to explore reality to the limit. We aim to create animation that is more real than life.
Akira, if you've seen it, is really probably the best animated film of its type. It's just constant movement, there's a lot of action, very violent, very dark. Sort of Blade Runner-like. It attracts that type of crowd. There was a large theatrical release for it here in 89. That started a groundswell of this type of material.
In the Japanese films where they spend, you know, it's all detail. They spend, you know, so much attention to detail and every little piece of trash that's, you know, like in Akira when trash is blowing and every little piece of trash is a different thing.
There are a certain type that are just sex-oriented or violent-oriented. It's a small minority. People, you know, some of those titles have gotten out and gotten a lot of press.
Anime in general, I like it all because it's different than what we do. I admire their, the ability to get the most out of the least. I think that's great.
But first, here's the weather forecast. Skies are clearing up thanks to a high pressure front moving in from the mountains. Mild winds will be blowing in from the west, pushing the clouds out by this evening. And there'll be a beautiful full moon lighting up the sky, so if you've been planning something special, tonight might be the night.
Anime is a style of animation that was developed from a Japanese art form called manga. Manga, the Japanese word for comics or comic strips, like those we see every day in U.S. newspapers, began in Japan in the early 1100s. The drawings were caricatures of animals used as a metaphor to express views on society at a time when to speak against the social order could result in severe punishment, even execution.
Manga, translated as comics, is a printed matter created by one creator.
One of the most famous manga artists of the 20th century is Mr. Reiji Matsumoto, who first became known for his work Honeybee Adventures.
I was 15 years old when I published Honeybee Adventures. I took manga in a new direction by adding drama and real issues to the stories, not just humor or political statements.
In America, comic books are a cult form of entertainment, but in Japan, they are a part of mainstream society. Popular manga weeklies can sell over 4 million copies per week. In 1994, over 1 billion comic books were published in Japan. That's 10 books for every man, woman, and child.
Half of the books sold in Japan are comic books. They are very well segmented by demographic group. They have books for young boys, young girls, young men who work in companies, young women who work in companies, the management level of men at companies, mother-in-laws. I mean, there's a lot of segmentation among the comic books so that every potential audience has a product that it can buy.
And there are also manga that are intended to be somewhat instructional, that deal with Japanese corporate culture and business practices, that are read by not only business people, but by the general public.
One of the best-selling series of manga books today is Salaryman, the everyday adventures of a young Japanese businessman, created by Kenshi Hirokani.
With most mangas, you have to do a lot of research, but since I was already working in the advertising department at Panasonic, I was able to write about my own experiences.
Avid fans of manga and anime are known as otaku.
Otaku is obsession. It's about being thoroughly focused and riveted on a certain aspect, some usually technologically driven aspect of contemporary society, whether it's computers, anime, manga, video games.
If you're a hardcore anime otaku, as we like to call him, he is very proud of the fact that he enjoys the original Japanese. He enjoys hearing the original Japanese voices, their inflection patterns. He likes hearing the songs in Japanese. He likes seeing the Japanese or the Chinese characters which are used in the Japanese writing. And he considers that the attempt to dub it, if you will, sort of dumbs it down, or it takes away some of that unique appeal. And many of our fans are very strong in their choice of a subtitled version.
Mr. Okada, a professor at the University of Tokyo, teaches a course on otaku culture.
American otakus interested in manga and anime try to learn the language to better understand the Japanese culture. It's very similar to when the Japanese imported American culture. A lot of Japanese people went to English conversation schools to learn more about the American way. I attended an animation expo in Los Angeles, and there were so many people interested in anime. They had keychains, posters, and it made me realize how the Americans are trying to understand the basic nuance of Japan through our animation.
This is just the kind of place I've always imagined. Look out below!
The degree to which one style of animation influences another is difficult to identify. The borrowing of styles and techniques is common practice in all forms of art. Animation is no exception. In the early days of the Japanese animation industry, Japanese animators were heavily influenced by the films of Walt Disney.
A new Disney film would come out, people would watch it, study it, and try to steal the techniques. Now animation in Japan has evolved into its own style and technique.
And now these techniques and ideas are flowing back to America, seeping into aspects of American life ranging from popular culture to television programming.
Got a phone call from somebody at HBO. And they said, you know, we represent HBO and we're interested in Spawn. And, you know, I had only one question for him at that time, which was, you know, can I cuss?
You really fucked yourself this time.
If you could cuss in the show, then that would open up a lot of other things, and I wouldn't be restricted. And I knew that this show couldn't be something that had to be contained in a very small box.
One warrior in the afterlife. One love he can't forget. One deal that can't be broken.
God ain't here, boy.
Let him go.
What the hell are you?
Spawn, you know, it's an age-old tragic drama. I mean, it's Faust, and that's the push.
I didn't want him, like I said, to go to the network, to come on Saturday morning cartoons, and to have him with a talking dog for a sidekick. That was like, I'd rather have no show than to have that.
Oh, but I think you're dealing with some misplaced anger here. Don't get pissed at me. I'm the one who's helping you out. I'm not the one who stole your wife.
It's fascinating to see how the different cultural influences come together. They interact, they bounce off each other. And the more of this that goes on, I think the more fascinating kind of programming we'll be seeing over the future years.
A lot of this stuff is seeping into the subculture, music culture. A lot of the skateboard kids, street kids, they love this stuff.
In 1998, Walt Disney will bring out a very famous Japanese animated movie called Princess Mononoke.
Princess Mononoke won the Japanese Academy Award for Best Picture of 1997. As of March 98, the film had taken in a record $152 million at the Japanese domestic box office, surpassing the record previously held by E.T.
We have many animators here inside the Disney Corporation who are very enthused by our relationship with Miyazaki and are also big fans of his.
In Japan, I saw the Princess Mononoke movie. Brilliant film. I'm a little bit curious as to what Disney will do with it because it's very deep. It makes Ralph Bashki's Lord of the Rings look like Bugs Bunny.
So it's thrilling to see how the Americans will receive my work and what kind of difficulties they will have understanding the story.
The Japanese anime style has influenced not only American animation, but in New York City's East Village, Michael Sears and Hushi Robot have incorporated anime images onto clothing and fashion accessories.
It's, you know, the image of, you know, these futuristic, big-eyed, like, creations are like what has always been a small driving force for me.
We made the cover of a Japanese-American magazine, and they did an article about the store and just about the whole Japanimation popular thing that's happening right now.
We are just starting to see the integration of Japanese animation into the American market.
One of our goals was to legitimize the genre by using professional video marketing techniques to bring this programming into the Blockbusters, the Towers, the HMVs, the large chain stores, things of that nature, and that's been successful.
Is an amalgamation of all things Japanese animated. We've opened two stores, we're opening a fourth within this year. We've been on the press and been press all over the country for this material.
Japanese animation and the reception it is getting with American animators and American audiences makes it clear that animation is no longer just for kids. Anime, along with groundbreaking shows such as The Simpsons, South Park, King of the Hill, and Spawn, are just the beginning.
Whether it's claymation, stop motion, or computer, or cell drawn, the different varieties of animation that are out there are starting to become almost, you know, animation and not just Japanese or Italian or French or American. It's animation.
Once you get the audience, then you have to move them, I believe, into an adult realm, because math tells me that if I appeal to a 5 to 15 year old, I've only got them for 10 years. If I can hook somebody at 16, I might have them till 66. That's 50 years. You know, people are adults a lot longer than their children.
What we're trying to do on the show is we're trying to be funny. We write about and draw funny pictures about issues that concern us all. We try to reflect the way we think the world is, kind of, if the world were full of people with, you know, overbites. And sometimes we tackle issues and sometimes we don't.
The cool thing about animation is we can go anywhere right now, you know, and we're trying to make a show where people really don't know what to expect.
Does anybody know any non-Santa or non-Jesus Christmas songs?
How about we sing, Kyle's Mom is a Stupid Bitch in D minor. I told you not to call my mom a bitch, Cartman. Well, Kyle's mom's a bitch, she's a big fat bitch, she's the biggest bitch in the whole wide world. She's a stupid bitch, if there ever was a bitch, she's a bitch to all the boys and girls. Shut up, Cartman!
As we approach different creators and remain true to be a creator-driven studio, we'll see a lot of different styles crop up that range from stick figures to anime. We'll see the wide range, and we embrace that.
While animation can make us laugh, it is more than silly pictures. Its ability to be anything, any shape, any color, allows storytellers to capture the full range of human emotions and visions never before seen on film.